Amen. Glory be to God. Thank God for the 12th hour. Amen. I didn't think I was going to make it today, but the 12th hour, God delivered me. Amen. Had an earache, dizzy and everything but God. But here I am tonight, and I thank God for allowing me to be here just one more time. Amen. And we come to lift up the name of Jesus during this time of pandemic. We all need to be revived. Amen. We all need to be revived, amen, to let us know that God is still sitting on the throne, amen, and looking down. And I'm so happy about it, amen. Glory, glory, hallelujah. Well, since I lay my burdens down, my burdens down, I say, glory, glory, hallelujah. Well, since I my burdens down, come on, everybody. Well, I say, glory, glory, hallelujah. I feel better now. I feel better. Since I laid my burdens down, my burdens down, I say, glory, glory, hallelujah. Well, since I my burdens down, I'm not lying, y'all. I do feel better now. Well, I feel better. So much better. Since I laid my burdens down, my burdens down, I say I feel better. Oh, so much better, oh yeah, since I laid my burdens down, my burdens down. I'm going home to, yes sir, I said to live with Jesus, oh yeah, since I laid, oh, my burden down, my burden, I said, now I feel it to thank you, Lord, I live with Jesus, oh, since I lay my burden down, my burden down, I say burden down. Lord, burdens down, Lord, since I lay my burdens down, my burdens down, I say burdens down, Lord, my burdens down, Lord. Go ahead, Pastor, since I got passed on the drum. My burdens down. Old friends ain't the same. Well, I say, friends don't treat me like they used to. Well, since I laid my burdens down, my burdens down, I say, friends don't. Like they used to. Well, since I laid my burden, everybody glory down. Come on, church. Well, I say glory, glory, hallelujah. Well, since I laid my Lord I say, glory, glory, hallelujah. Well, since I lay, one more verse, I'm going home. My bird, you ready, Ham? Go with me, Ham. Well, I say, I'm going home to, to live with Jesus. Since I lay my burden down, my burden down, I say, I'm going home to, to live with Jesus. Well, since I laid my burden down. Amen.
Amen. This evening's scripture will be coming from the book of John, St. John, chapter 14. Book of St. John, chapter 14, starting at verse 1. Say amen when you've reached it. And it reads, let not your heart be troubled. Ye believe in God, believe also in me. In my Father's house are many mansions. If it were not so, I would have told you. I go to prepare a place for you. And if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come again and receive you unto myself, that where I am, there ye be also.
Yes.
And whither I go, ye know the way ye know. Thomas saith unto him, Lord, we know not whither thou goest, and how can we know the way? Jesus said unto him, I am the way, the truth, and the life. No man cometh unto the Father but by me. May the Lord add a blessing to the reading and the hearing of his holy word.
Let us pray. Eternal God and all-wise Father, Lord God, here we are again.
Yes, Father.
We come tonight, Father God, on this Monday evening, Lord God.
Yes.
We come, Lord God, to lift up your holy name. We come to praise your holy name, Father God. We come to hear word from you tonight, Father God.
Yes.
Lord, we are here, Father, because last night, Father, you kept us. You watched over us. As we laid in our bed, Father God.
Yes, Father.
Sleeping, not knowing what's going on around us, Lord. You touched us with your finger, love, Father. And you allowed us to wake up one more time. Yes. And Lord God, I don't know about nobody else. I stopped by to tell you thank you. When I woke up this morning, Lord God, pain wrapping all through my body, Father God. From the sole of my feet to my head, Father. But Lord God, you still woke me up and gave me one more chance, Father. So Lord God, I don't take it for granted, Father God.
No, Father.
I don't take it for granted, Lord God, because Lord God, you sent your only begotten Son down through 42 generations, Father God. You sent them down, Lord God, because you knew that this world would be messed up. You knew, Lord God, that this world needed a Savior, Father God. So we thank you for your Son, Jesus, Lord.
Thank you, Lord.
Just in his name, Father God, we ask right now. Please, Father, give us of our sins, both knowingly and unknowingly, Lord God. We all come up short tonight. But Lord God, because of your grace and your mercy, Father, we ask that you give us one more chance. Lord God, we come today to glorify your name. We come to magnify your name, Father God. For Lord God, you've been good to us, better than we would ever be to ourselves, Father God. Nobody but you, Father God, can love us so much, Father God. Oh Lord God, have mercy to your name, Father God. Bless this week. Revival, Father God. Bless each of you who will stand behind your faith today. And preach your word to a dying world, Father. Oh, Lord God, let your word go forth, Father God, that it may penetrate hearts and minds, that minds may be changed, Father God, that hearts may be fixed,
Lord God. But most of all,
oh Lord, praise on, praise.
Yeah. Oh
Lord, yes,
we need your word, Father God.
Yes, sir.
We need your Holy Spirit, Lord God, that we may go out into this dying world and tell somebody about the Savior who died. But yet we still.
Oh yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Oh Lord God, I thank you.
Oh yes.
I thank you for Jesus, Father.
Thank you, Lord.
I thank you for Jesus.
Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Oh, thank you, Lord. Yes, Father God. Praise, Son.
Have mercy right
oh,
now.
Oh, have God, mercy.
On the Friendship family, Lord God. And all the churches, Lord God, in the area, Father God. Bless each and every pastor, Lord God, as we are going through this pandemic, Father.
Oh, Lord.
Give them the wisdom, Father, Lord God, to lead your people, to build your people, to give your people insight, to give them guidance.
Oh, yeah. Praise,
Father,
Son.
Thank you,
Lord.
I thank you for Dr. Dunham.
Thank
God.
You, Lord.
Lord God, you showed up.
Thank you, Lord.
You showed up, Father.
Oh, thank you, Lord.
You sent us the leader, Father God. You sent us the leader, Father
oh,
God.
Oh, thank you, Lord.
We didn't vote him in, Lord God. You sent him here, Lord God, we thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Lord, today.
For his teaching. For his preaching, Lord God. But most of all, Father God, I thank you for allowing him, Lord God, to be you, Father God. Have mercy right now, Father
have
God.
Have mercy, Lord.
Know that you're able, Father God.
Have mercy,
in the name
Lord.
Of Jesus.
Jesus.
Continue to touch his wife, Father God. In the name of Jesus. Continue to touch the sick, Father God. In the name of Jesus, Father God.
Thank you, Lord.
Come to them free, Father God.
Yeah.
In the name of Jesus, Father God. In the name of Jesus.
Jesus.
We tell you,
thank you.
We tell you, thank you, Father.
Thank
God.
You.
And Lord God, not to be selfish. Lord God, I thank you for allow me, Lord God, if
oh,
it be
yeah.
your will,
yeah.
to travel these highways and these byways.
Oh, yes, sir.
On an airplane, Father God.
Thank you, Lord.
And go see my family.
Yeah.
Oh, Lord God, bless me, Lord God.
Please.
Get down, Father God.
Yeah.
See the Christ in me, Father.
Please.
God. And Lord God, watch over my family.
Master, please, today.
Watch over my wife and keep her.
Please, Lord.
Only you know how, Father.
Only you know.
When it's all over, Sandra.
Yes.
We'll be so careful.
Oh, yeah.
Honor,
oh, yes, sir.
Glory,
oh, yeah.
It's in Jesus' name.
Jesus'
name. The one who died, we can still live. For when I
yes.
Sunday morning.
Oh, yes, sir.
All power.
Oh, power.
It's in his name, I tell you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Amen. Thank you.
Thank you. Amen. In the hands of the pulpit. Thank you.
Hallelujah.
Yeah.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. The Lord is good. He's blessed us one more time. He's brought us back together.
Yes, sir.
You know, one more time. Don't take it for granted. Don't take it for granted. I took a place I worked at for 30 years for granted. Before I knew it, COVID had took it. And the building ain't even there no more. But God. God made a way.
What you say?
That I'm in another building.
Nobody but God. Amen.
And we thank God for that.
Yes, sir. Give the name of
as we come now to welcome you here to our annual revival. I wanna let you know that I understand better this year what revival meant than any time. I understand what it means to be revived because I needed reviving. In every way, I needed reviving. But the Lord, he touched my soul. And he revived me. So I say to you, I'm going to ask the Lord to let this revival begin in me. And I thank him for it. I thank everybody over the airways and all of those that are here, the pastor, deacons, the devotion, and we want to bless the preacher, the revivalist that's going to come, and give us a word from the Lord. We thank you so much. We're going to ask you right now, if you don't mind, to come to the altar. Oh, yeah, the solo. I'm sorry, excuse me. First, we're going to have a solo by Brother Leroy Hamilton. And then we will have altar prayer. Amen. Brother Hamilton.
Okay, there we go. Amen. Amen. Good evening, church. I'm good. I'm good. I'm good.
All right.
The storms just keeps on raging in my life. And sometimes it's hard to till the night from day. Oh,
yeah.
But still the hope that lies within is reassured. If I keep my eyes upon the distant shore, I know he'll lead me safely to that blessed place he has prepared. But if the storm don't cease, and if the winds keeps on blowing in my life, my soul has been anchored in the Lord. Sometimes in this life, we're gonna be tossed by the waves and the current that seems so fierce. One thing I like about it is the word of God. The word of God has me anchored, and it keeps me steadfast, and I move abroad in spite the tide. But if the storm don't cease, and just in case the winds keeps on blowing, blowing in my life, my soul has been anchored, in the Lord. My soul, the billows may roll and the breakers may dash. I will not sway because they hold me fast. So dark at day, clouds in the sky, I know it's all right, cause Jesus is not by my soul. My soul, my soul, my soul, my soul, my soul. Have your soul, my soul has been anchored. Oh,
Amen, amen, amen. My soul, my soul has been anchored in the Lord. My soul. Amen, amen, amen. What a wonderful selection to sing in this revival. We thank Brother Hamilton for that wonderful spiritual selection. And now we're going to ask those that are here if they want mind to come to the altar. Or you can just kneel where you are. But we're asking you over the airways to do the same, to kneel down now. And let the Lord come in. Won't you call on him tonight? Call on Jesus and tell him that you need him.
I need thee.
Call on Jesus tonight and let him know that through it all, you depend and trust in him. Our Father, which art in heaven, hallowed be thy name in all the earth. We thank you now, Lord, for allowing us to come in your presence with a word from our heart. With the word of prayer, Lord, that we know that only you can hear and only you can receive what we are saying tonight. Because, Lord, you know all the ups and all the downs that we have been through. And what makes it so good, Father, we know that you know what we're going to go through. We know, Father, that you have got everything
in control.
So now, Lord, we just at the Friendship family, just want to recognize that you've been good.
You've been good.
We want to give you glory and honor for all that you've done.
All glory, all glory.
All that you're doing and all that you're going to do. To let you know, Father, that you've been in charge all the time. To let you know, Lord,
talk to him, talk to him, talk to him.
It's been you.
You, Lord.
That woke us up. It's been you that has laid us down. It was you, Father, that kept the virus off of us.
Hallelujah.
It's been you, Lord, that,
today.
That made the ones well, that got the virus. It was you that took your time to help us and guide us through this barren land. And we thank you, Lord. We thank you.
Thank you.
We're asking you now to bless the preacher. To give the preacher a word. To let your spirit run
please,
over.
Please.
To guide him, Father.
Please guide him, Master.
And then bless all the preachers that's going to come.
Yes, Lord.
Forth this week.
Please, Jesus, please.
Give them what they need, Lord.
Hallelujah. Yes, sir.
That the world might know that there's a revival going on here.
Yes.
At Friendship.
Yes, sir.
We want the world to know, Lord, that it's your hand that's moving on our hearts.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
We want the world to know, Father, that
thank you, Lord.
If it had not been for you.
Oh, God.
On our side.
Mm-hmm.
Where would we be?
Where would we be? Good God Almighty. Thank you, Lord.
We thank you so much, Lord.
Thank you.
We just thank you. That's just ain't enough thank you. Ain't enough time to keep on saying thank you, Father. Because you've just been that good.
You've been just that good.
You've been more better to me than I've been to myself.
Yes, sir.
You kept your arms around me when I kept trying to get away.
Yes. Thank
it
you, Lord.
It was you.
Thank you, Lord. It was you, Lord. Thank you, Lord.
That does it.
Thank
been
you, Lord.
Doing it and still doing it.
Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you.
Thank you for blessing.
Thank you, Lord.
Our pastor.
Thank you, Master.
For giving him
oh, God.
Vision.
Yes.
On how to lead
oh,
your
thank you. Thank you, Lord.
To a closer walk.
Yes, sir. Thank you.
And now, Lord.
Now, Lord.
We want to go just a little bit higher.
Yes, sir.
In your word.
Mm-hmm.
In your service.
Yes.
We want to do what is pleasing unto you.
In your sight, Master. Yes, sir.
Lord.
Please.
We thank you.
Thank you, Lord.
It's in Jesus' name.
Jesus.
We pray in Jesus' name.
Hallelujah, Jesus.
We thank you.
Thank you, Lord.
Amen.
Amen.
And bless God.
Thank you, Lord.
Amen. 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 Amen.
Thank you, Lord.
Amen.
Thank you, Lord.
And now we're going
Hallelujah.
To have the dance troupe to come mm-hmm. at this time. Amen. Can we give her a round of applause as she comes, please? Amen. Amen.
You
Come on and put your hands together and bless God in this house. Come on. Put your hands together and bless God in this house. Oh, we've been blessed thus far. I wanted to just come up and thank God for all that has transpired thus far to our officers and to our ministers and certainly to all of you that are here and to you that are out on Facebook and conference call. We are in for a great time today. We are in for a great time. Our deacons fired us up with a revived devotion. And then our pulpit director, Reverend Huntley, fired us up with a dynamic altar prayer. And I thank Brother Leroy Hamilton for singing a song that out of his heart to lift our hearts and lift our spirits. And I feel good. I feel good because it lets me know I wasn't the only one needed reviving. You know, we get stale sometimes. We get comfortable sometimes. And things like this ought to inspire us. And so I'm grateful to God for all that's transpiring in this pandemic season. Amen. We are yet holding on. We are yet trusting in our God. We're going to bring up our preacher. We want you to hear him. We want you, if you would be so kind. We're asking all that would plant a seed in this harvest. If you would plant a $50 seed, we want you to have it be comfortable on PayPal or on Givelify. Or you can go and just drop it off in the old post office box. And we'll be glad to receive it and thank you for it. But this is what we want to do to be a blessing to our ministers. Will you help us today? All right. We're going to be here Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, and Friday if the Lord says the same. And we're going to have us a great revival, a great opportunity to be renewed. And I'm challenging everyone on Facebook. Do you need to be revived? I want you to look at yourself. The text I sent out, it says, Lord, send us a revival. But it said, let it begin in me. You have to take it personal and private. If you do that, God will set your heart on Hollywood fire. And I'm here to tell you, you'll know how much he loves you. That's all what revival does. It reminds you how much he loves you. And then thanks, Sister April, for that beautiful dance. God bless you. Thank you. We're going to ask her husband to come up now and bring us a message, Reverend Antoine Dominique. Allow him to come and preach. Thank you so much.
Amen. Mm-hmm. Start off in a word of prayer. Our God and our Father, Lord, we thank you. We thank you, Lord, for bringing us here one more night. We thank you, Lord, for watching over us all night, all day, for feeding us when we don't deserve it. Thank you, Lord, for your love, your peace, your joy, your many gifts. We love you, Lord, on this day. We praise your name. We come to be revived, re-energized, encouraged on tonight, on this dark road. But we know that you are the light in the valley. We thank you, Lord. Please forgive me for my many sins. Please use me on tonight. We thank you, Lord. In the name of Jesus, we pray. The mighty name of Jesus. Amen and amen. God is good. God is good. I thank God for tonight. Thank God for another opportunity. Thank God for our pastor, the angel of this house. Let us continue to keep him in prayer. He didn't have to give me another opportunity, and I thank him for this. Each one of the preachers, each one of the deacons, and my mother. God bless my mother. Keep her in prayer. We need to stay protected. Amen. To my wife, Sister April, to each one of you, my brothers and sisters in Christ, to my in-laws, it's good to be in the house of the Lord one more time. If you have your Bibles this evening, you have your Bibles, and if you don't mind standing for the Word of God, and to each one of you watching tonight, we're coming out of the Lord's Gospel according to Matthew, the 15th chapter, of Matthew. We start reading at the 35th verse. Matthew 15, verses 35. Are we there? Amen. It says, "And he commanded the multitude to sit down on the ground. And he took the 7 loaves and the fishes and gave thanks and broke them and gave to his disciples and the disciples to the multitude. And they did all eat and were filled. And they took up of the broken meat that was left 7 baskets full. And they that did eat were 4,000 men beside women and children. And he sent away the multitude and took ship and came into the coast of Magdala." You may be seated. So reads God's holy word. This is part 2 of the Lord's compassion. The Lord's compassion. My peace in the pandemic. Brothers and sisters, I want to remind us this evening that there is nothing too hard for God. It was King David that said in the 37th number of Psalms, "I was young, and now I am old. Yet have I not seen the righteous forsaken, nor his seed begging bread." King David also said in the 27th number of Psalms, "Yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil. For thou, not the ceiling, not the stars, not the sun, not the moon, but thou, God, art with me. Thy rod and thy staff, they comfort me. Surely goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life." Yeah. I have come tonight to encourage us. We serve a good God. A God that goes out of his way to help us. He goes out of his way to bless us. We can ask ourselves this evening, what hasn't God done for us? Countless upon countless of times he showed up. But only times when he didn't show up is when we were disobedient by not following his word. But thank God for being God. Because if he wouldn't have looked over our faults and saw all of our needs, we would be in the worst of state. That's why we can thank God for Jesus. It's Jesus who helps us in the times of our trouble, which is right now. Matter of fact, it was Jesus who King David was saying in the 23rd number of Psalm, the Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. He maketh me to lie down in green pastures. He leadeth me beside still waters. I'm just trying to tell you about the Messiah's compassion. His compassion doesn't have a color line on it. His compassion is free for all who are willing to follow him. Our first point tonight, brothers and sisters, is Christ's compassion knows what's best for us. Number one, Jesus Christ knows what we need before we need it. He already has the plan planned out. Tell your neighbor, neighbor, God has the plan mapped out. He got it mapped out. And it's for my good. He knows what we need before we even think about it. That's a good God. The Lord told them to sit down. I remember Pastor on Wednesday said, we're going to make it. God got it all in control. He told them to sit down. It's time to eat. Sometimes God has to sit us down to get our attention. When Jesus rules over us, we shouldn't mind obeying him. Jesus said, sit down on the ground. If you go back to the 14th chapter, Jesus says, sit down on the grass. Can I say, brothers and sisters, both of these times, Jesus, the disciples, and the multitudes were in the desert. They were in the desert. Can I tell you tonight, it matters not about wherever you are in your life. If you're in jail, God will provide. If you're homeless, he'll provide. If you're in the crack house, he'll provide. The White House, the sick bed, he'll provide. God has his children in his hand. It don't matter where we are. If you're obeying God, get ready for your blessing. We're not in this race for the blessings. But thank God for blessing us for following him. In verse 36, Jesus took the loaves and he took the fish. He prayed for the food and he began to break it off. We see Jesus praying. The Messiah leading by example. Jesus Christ, he prayed. Before we do anything, we ought to pray. If Jesus prayed, why do we think we shouldn't pray? I have to ask the question tonight, are we talking to God? If these times don't show us that we need to talk to the Lord, I don't know what times will. If you look through the Gospels, you'll see Jesus praying all the time. He prayed all the time. But now we see Jesus praying for the food he's about to give out. What an example. Prayer is important. It's vital. It's essential for the believer. Romans 14 said, he that regardeth the day regardeth it unto the Lord. And he that regardeth it not to the day, to the Lord he doth not regard it. He that eateth, eateth to the Lord. For he giveth God thanks. And he that eateth not to the Lord, he eateth not and giveth God thanks. He don't give him thanks. 1 Corinthians 10 tells us, whether therefore ye eat or drink, or whatsoever ye do, do all to the glory of God. Tell your neighbor, neighbor, we got to pray to the Father. And make sure we always finish our prayer off with the name of Jesus. But brothers and sisters, I have to ask the question this evening. Why didn't Jesus make the bread fall down from heaven? Why didn't Jesus hit a rock and make the rocks give water? Why didn't God just make food appear in all of their hands? And I've come to understand that God can do everything at any time. He made bread fall down from heaven at that time. He made water come out of the rock at that time. Which shows me at any time in this pandemic, without a job, on your sick bed, broken, by yourself, all alone, he's able to meet you in your time. Every time. There's nothing impossible to God. It doesn't matter what kind of circumstance we may be in. I'm trying to tell you, if the Lord is with you, he's able to do amazing things. There were 7 loaves and 3 fish. Jesus had these few pieces of things to work with. Just a few. Just a little bit. Which brings me to my second point. God does his best work with just a little bit. He does his best work with a little bit. This isn't the first time God had to use a little bit. In Judges 15, God allowed Samson to kill thousands of men with one jawbone. In 1 Samuel, you remember little old David only had 5 smooth stones. Against a giant called Goliath. And it only took 1 stone to kill Goliath. It's not what you have, it's who has you. So the little we have in our refrigerators. Back in the day, they used to say the little we have in our ice boxes. The little we have in our bank accounts, in our life insurance, our 401k, our IRAs, with God, it can go a long way. it can go a long way. I know I'm not alone today. I might not have a lot, but I know who I got. And he's all. Jesus is all I need. It was the Lord Jesus himself that made man out of the dust of ground. Doing big things with a little bit. It was God who made woman out of a rib, out of a man. I'm just trying to tell you tonight, God does his best work with just a little bit. The little bit in the Lord's hands began to break off. I don't know how he did it, but he did it. It might have been like this. It might have been like this. I don't know. But he did it. When God starts going, there's no stopping. And it's a sight to see. When it starts going, it's on automatic. I can see Jesus saying, "What you got? Give it to me." Boom, bam, pow. It wasn't no magic, but he made it happen. It multiplied. Jesus gave the food to the disciples. And the disciples gave the food to the multitude, which was over 10,000 people. Isaiah 55 said, "Ho, everyone that thirsteth, come ye to the waters. And he that hath no money, come ye, buy and eat." What we receive from the Lord, brothers and sisters, we can't keep to ourselves. We got to share it. We must give it to others. We might not have food to give. We might not have money to give. We might not have clothes. But the gift of Jesus, when you give it out, can't get no better. They were operated by God's word. They were ordered by the Lord. The text says tonight in closing, everybody ate. Everybody ate. Don't miss this. With the Lord, please don't miss this. Psalms 107 says, "For he satisfied the longing soul, and filleth the hungry soul with goodness." Yeah. Isaiah 58 said, "And the Lord shall guide thee continually, and satisfy thy soul in drought, and make fat thy bones, and thou shalt be like the watered garden, and like a spring of water, whose waters fail not. The Lord will provide for his children." Since we know this one thing, we shouldn't worry about tomorrow. My peace in these times of trials and tribulation is my faith in the Lord bringing me through. Because he has true compassion for me. And I know Jesus knows what's best for me. And it doesn't matter what we have, because he does his best work with just a little bit. I'm closing tonight. The best is yet to come. The best is yet to come. Don't worry. The Lord said in Matthew 6, "Therefore take no thought for your life, what ye shall eat, on what ye shall drink, nor yet for the body, what ye shall put on. Is not the life more than meat, and the body than raiment?" Isaiah 57 says, There is no peace, saith my God, to the wicked. If you're trusting in God, if you're trusting in Jesus, everything is going to be all right. Don't worry. The best is yet to come. The text says everybody was filled. I have to tell you, my parents can cook some good ribs, collard greens, yams, glazed ham, some thick gravy, and black-eyed pea. My wife can cook some mac and cheese, catfish, spaghetti with meatballs, and I just had some frog legs. And can I tell you, it was good. But the bellies get full off food. But the bellies go hungry again. Mama, there's nothing like that red velvet cake. But there's nothing like spiritual food. Can't nothing fill you like the Holy Spirit. Once you get them, you stay full. And you're done searching. And you can't get enough. Nothing can fill our spirits like the Holy Spirit. Does anybody have joy in this place tonight? John 15 told me, these things I have spoken unto you, that my joy might remain in you, and that your joy, our joy, may be filled. Is anybody full of God in this place? Is anybody satisfied with Jesus? Matthew 5 told me, blessed are they which are hungry and thirst after righteousness, for they shall be filled. Ephesians 3 said, and to know the love of Christ, which passes knowledge, that ye might be filled with all fullness of God. When we're full of the Spirit, there's no place of being full of anything else. They were full. And here's the good news. God gave them more than what they needed. Somebody other than myself can say that they've been overblessed. They've been overblessed in their life. Talk about a superabundance. The seven baskets were full. Now, these weren't small baskets. These baskets were the size of men. How do I know that? Well, in Acts 9, it was Saul in Acts 9 that was full of fear of his life. But now he was full of Christ. After being full of Christ, his now enemies sought out to kill him. Can I tell you, the disciples heard about his enemies wanting to kill him. And the disciples, they put Saul in a basket. And they lowered Saul down the wall in a basket. That basket was the same size of the baskets that were full in our text. So these were large baskets full of food. I'm just trying to tell you, God over blesses us. Yeah, we're going through a tough time today. We're going through a tough time in our life. But the same God who saved Israel from Egypt is the same God who can bring us through. Same God can bring us through today. The same God gives us our peace today. He fills us in these times of wickedness. So I don't have to worry about Corona. Don't have to worry about money or food. Don't have to worry about my enemies, because I got Jesus and he got me. I know, I said I know, Jesus got me. He got me in his hand. And if you're in his hands, can't no man, no man, nobody, not nothing, can pluck you out of his hand. No one can take us from the love of God. A cop might pull the trigger on you, but if you're in God's hand, you'll be all right. I said you'll be all right. Everything, everything, everything will be all right. Racists might surround us. Everything will be all right. Oh, Lord, I'm trying to tell you, God has us in his mighty hands. Come what may, I'm in God's hand. And God got everything in control. I know he can, and I know he will bring us through. He can turn it around. He will turn it around. Won't he turn it around? The best is yet to come. Jesus knew. He knew what we needed. Christ does his best work with just a little bit. He did his best work with just a little bit. Didn't he do his best work with just a little bit? Oh, Lord, he did his best work on a hill called Calvary. Oh, Lord, at Calvary on Friday, they hung him high. That didn't kill him. The nails didn't kill him. The nails didn't keep him up. It was love that kept him up. Oh, love. Love kept him on the cross. For you and for me. For you and for me. Thank God. Thank God for his love. It kept him on that cross. And he stayed dead all night Friday. And all day. All day Saturday. And all night Saturday. Oh, Lord, God is good. Ain't God good? Ain't he good? He stayed dead. But oh, Lord, oh, Lord, oh, Lord, ain't God all right? On Sunday, Sunday, he got up for you and for me. Didn't he get up? Say yeah, yeah, oh yeah. He got up with all power, power. I said power in his hand. He always had the power, but he wanted to make sure that you knew he still had power, power to save, power to keep you, power to heal you. Power to bring us through. Power to change your mind. Power to change your heart. Power. He still got power. Power ain't gonna leave him. He gonna keep the power. He got all power. Power. Oh, yes. Thank God for Jesus. Jesus. Be encouraged. God is good. God is good. Hallelujah. Bless your name, Jesus.
Let's all say, let's all say amen. Come on, let's say amen. We've got that power. Thank God for a compassionate God. Then maybe thank God for the young man. Give him a big hand, will you? Give him a big hand. God bless you. Preached out of his heart. He set this revival on a hot track. And we want to keep that on tomorrow if the Lord let us live. Right now, I want to offer someone on Facebook who might not know Jesus as Lord and Savior. Mayhaps you got online, you happened across our website, you picked up on our Facebook, but somehow you got involved and you listened to the singing and you were taking part in the preaching and you heard that there is a Savior for your sins. Now, make no mistake about it. If you are not saved, if you have not accepted Jesus Christ as your personal Lord and Savior, you're a sinner. And that's no problem. There's no problem there. We all been that. But the good news is we've been translated into being the saved because we accepted Christ Jesus as our personal Lord and Savior. I want to extend that same right and privilege to you. You can change from sinner to saint right now. You can change your address from Hell Boulevard to Hallelujah Lane right now. And it's as simple as ABC. Acknowledge you're a sinner. Believe that the price he paid on Calvary was sufficient to cover your penalty sin. And then confess him as your Lord and Savior. If you do that, my God, you'll be saved and you'll be a member of the body of Christ. And if you would be so kind, write us a letter. Let us know that that was you that accepted Christ. Let us know that was you that want to be a part of this body of baptized believers. And oh my God, we will celebrate your name. All minds are clear, Brother Chairman. Did we receive an offering tonight? Amen. Thank you. Yes, I did. Thank you, Brother Chairman. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. That's my financial chairman over there. Thank you, Brother Chairman. All minds are clear. Stand to your feet. I want you on Facebook, please. I want you on conference call, please. Repeat after me. Lord. Come on, y'all. Lord. Send us a revival. Lord.
Lord,
send us a revival.
Send us a revival.
Lord,
send us a revival. Send us a
revival. And let it begin.
And let it begin.
In me.
In me.
Go with God and we'll close on Friday night. Amen. God bless you and God keep you. Thank you.